APSIPA into a section. Today is December 3rd, 2012. I'm Jasmine Wong. Today I'm very glad to invite the Professor Chen from Taiwan National Taiwan University to join us for this interview. So Professor Chen's many research interests is centered on multimedia signal processing and video compression. So hi, I'm Professor Chen. Could you please give us a brief introduction to your research lab?
Okay. I went back to Taiwan in 2003. Mm-hmm. I started this lab. We call it multimedia signal processing and communications. My lab basically is doing research on multimedia signal processing and communications. So within this umbrella, we did some work on image processing for digital camera, video compression, image processing for display, and also ways to facilitate efficient video communications. So that's roughly the scope of my research projects.
Okay. So my first question is based on one of your research topic. I see, I read one interesting topic such as emotion-based music accompaniment system. So could you give us a brief introduction to it?
Oh, sure. It's basically the research, and this research we try to figure out how to generate a music that has a certain emotion. Mm. Suppose you want to hear a song with a certain emotion, let's say a happy or sad. Mm. Then how do we change the accompaniment to accomplish that? So that's basically what it is. So in short, it's about a given melody, and we want to generate accompaniment. When this accompaniment is played together with the melody, it will produce the kind of emotion that you wish to have.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. It's quite interesting. This was done by a very junior member of my lab. Mm-hmm. She's now at Stanford University.
Oh, Stanford. Okay. So, Professor Chen, you have been working for many years both in industry and academic areas. So, could you give us some advice how to choose your career path, industry or academia?
First of all, I would say there's really no good or bad.
Mm-hmm.
I guess in terms of choosing or making a decision for your career, there are quite a few things that you have to be clear about. The first one is you should understand the nature of these two different types of careers. Okay, an academia job is very different from industry job. It's very different.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you understand. If I become a professor, for example, what are the kind of things that I will be doing? Okay, and whether I like it or not. So you have to figure out first. Same thing, right? If you say try to analyze what they do in industry, then you have to ask yourself, is that the kind of work I want to do?
I see.
Okay. So you have to make that decision. I think, unfortunately, these two paths are not in parallel. They could be orthogonal to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So that means once you decide to go in this direction, then there's no way out. You have to stick in that direction. It's difficult to switch to academia sometimes. So you better make a very good decision at the beginning that's good for you. I think the second element there is you have to understand yourself. What is your interest?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then once you have that on the table, I think the decision is easy to make.
Oh, I see.
That's my view. Yeah.
Yes, that's very helpful. So, Professor, you as a professor, you must have many different kind of jobs, such as editoring stuff and doing research. So how do you manage your time at the end?
Oh, I suppose, don't promise too much. Just here, I think in terms of time management, I think it's mainly about prioritization. You have to prioritize your work clearly, and then just follow the priority.
Mm-hmm.
And then sometimes you do have to say no to our requests. Because you know, we only have 24 hours a day. So I think that's my experience. That's the key for that. Just understand your priority. And also, there's another thing that's quite important, is that you plan well. Don't try to do things in the last minute.
Mm-hmm.
And have a good plan. That helps.
Okay, so plan carefully.
That's right.
So as a junior researcher, I always want to know how to write a high-quality paper.
Oh.
So could you give us some advice?
Well, I'm not sure if I'm the best person to answer that question. Some of it, my papers are pretty crappy. But in general, I would say, I think there are several elements in terms of high quality paper, right?
Mm-hmm.
The first thing is always this timing issue there, right? Mm-hmm. The topic has to be timely, otherwise nobody read it, right? So the timing issue.
Mm-hmm.
And so for that, then you have to understand the entire landscape of the field. Okay. Then once that's done, then it comes to a selection of your research paper,
mm-hmm.
right? And there, there's always a trade-off between something you can solve quickly versus something that could be very challenging, right? So you have to make a conscious decision there to see which one you want. Sometimes we intentionally choose an easy topic. Sometimes we try to face the challenge, face on. Now in terms of quality paper, of course, I mentioned timing, then the other one is the significance of the topic.
Mm-hmm.
Both, I think both are equally important. Right? Then here comes the third component, and that is the writing skill. Like the quality of writing has to be good. I think for most of us coming from the country, I think the rule of thumb there is to write clearly. If the paper, if the quality and the clarity of the paper is good, then people can understand it.
Mm-hmm.
You write the paper so that people can understand what you do, so clarity is another factor. Quite important there.
Mm-hmm. So, Professor, you must have attended many international conferences, so could you give us some tips on how to successfully present your work?
Well, again, I'm not sure if I'm the best person to answer that question because I don't think I'm a good presenter. But in general, I think there are a couple of key points. I think very much like in the paper writing, recently the paper writing. First, you want to make sure that you get the points across. You have to understand what the audience will be interested in. Then you talk in their language. Okay, so you have to understand. Do some analysis of the audience. And then tailor your talk to a specific audience. Then when you're up there giving the talk, I think it's quite important to describe your ideas in simple words. In simple words, you know. And then, you know, try to make it such that even your grandma can understand it. I think that's important.
Okay.
So once you get that down, I think the rest should be simple.
Mm.
Right, so that's my experience. I'm still working very hard at it. I have a long way to go.
So one last question.
Yeah.
When you have like junior PhD students,
yeah.
Is your manage choice of research topic or assigned also?
Yeah.
So how do you choose a research topic for your junior PhD students?
Well, most of the time, I don't decide the topic for my students. define the topic themselves.
Okay.
Yeah, but I do point out certain areas because you know I only know so much, so their topic has to be within my knowledge domain, right? So, but I let them choose it. I think they're quite, again, here, could be, you know, there could be a few guidelines, general guidelines. The first one is very much like what you, what we said earlier about the career, making the decision for your career or writing a paper. You have to understand the field, okay, and what is the state of the art, and what are the important, problems. Then once this is clear, I think it's very easy for you to pick up a problem to work out. I do want to tell junior researchers that don't be afraid of challenge. Okay, there are always two sides to a coin. Like if it's very challenging, then you can tackle it and solve it successfully. Then that means you get better fame out of it, or you become more successful. If you tackle a very easy problem, then the entry barrier is very small, very low, then anybody else can do it. So you have to make a compromise.
Thank you, Professor, for sharing your valuable experience.
My pleasure. All right. Thank you.